land of Israel. So just the mere fact that they'd be crying over loved ones dying, you know, or any kind of calamities happening to them, that proves that they're not the people. And, you know, this right here is one of our favorite go-tos that proves without a shadow of a doubt that those people are not the actual Israelites. Micah 4:1, it says, but in the last days it shall come to pass that the mountain of the house of the Lord, Yahabashim Yahushai, shall be established in the top of the mountains, and it shall be exalted above the hills, and people shall flow unto it. Now, mountains in the scriptures represent governments. So, in the last days, it shall come to pass that the mountain of the house of the Lord, or the government of the house of the Lord, shall be established in the top of the mountain. So the nation of Israel will have the top government on the planet Earth when they get set back in that land. Now, if they're the top government, why the hell are they getting bombed by a no-name, you know, a nothing group that's in the Gaza Strip? This small group called Hamas, man. Why would they even be able to shoot rockets on you if you're the top government, you're the strongest nation on the earth? It says, and he shall be exalted above the hills, and people shall flow into it. And you don't see everybody trying to go over to the land of Israel. Well, right now, people don't want to go over there. People's going to stay away because of what's going on over there right now, man. It says, and many nations shall come and say, come and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, the government of Yahabashim Yahushai, and to the house of the power of Jacob, and he will teach us of his ways, and we will walk in his paths, for the law shall go forth of Zion, and the word of the Lord, Yahabashim Yahushai, from Jerusalem. And this ain't happening either. Those Palestinians, they don't want nothing to do with you Israelis. They're not going over, you know, into your land, crossing the borders, and telling you to teach them about the Torah. They got their own religion. When the kingdom of heaven is established and the true Israelites are put back in that land, you ain't going to have these nations doing their own thing, man. They're going to be following the code that Yahabashim Yahushai gave to the nation of Israel, the law. That's what they're going to be following. And they're going to be worshiping Yahabashim Yahushai. They're not going to be bound down to these other gods. It says, and he shall judge among many people and rebuke strong nations afar off, and they shall beat their swords into plowshares and their spears into pruning hooks. Nation shall not lift up sword against nation, neither shall they learn war anymore. So there ain't going to be no more wars when the actual Israelites get established back in that land. Which just proves what? Those people are not who they say they are. Or these things wouldn't be going down. Now, the Most High is a liar. But the scriptures tell you that the Most High is not a man that he should lie. So those individuals are not who they say they are. And prophecy proves it. Which, that's the reason why these Christians don't like us going into prophecy, man. They don't want to deal with it. And this will be the last one. We'll close out on this. Which this is also on there. Deuteronomy 30. And I'll start at 1. They said this was fulfilled. Verse 3 through 5. Deuteronomy 30 and 1. It says, and this shall come to pass when all these things that come upon thee, the blessing and the curse, which... When did those people ever experience the curses, man? When you go into their history, they'll say that they've always had the Torah since they left, Israel during 70 AD. They've kept their customs. That's what they'll tell you. You know, you got a 2,000-year-old Torah that's big as hell that they've been walking around with for thousands of years. And they've kept it and preserved it, and now it's back in the land of Israel. They'll actually tell you that, man. But according to the curses, that wouldn't be so. The nation of Israel will forget who they were. It says, this will come to pass when all these things that come upon thee, the blessing and the curse, which I have set before thee, and thou shalt call them to mind among all the nations, whither the Lord, Yahabashim Yahushai, thy power hath driven thee, and thou shalt return unto the Lord, Yahabashim Yahushai, thy power, indicating what? That at one time the nation of Israel strayed away from the Heavenly Father. They put off the laws and the customs that were given to them. They put off their heritage and they follow after the customs of the heathen. That cannot be true for these 1948ers, because they'll tell you they've always had those customs. They never forgot who they were. They knew that they were Judah, Benjamin, Levi, going all the way back to when the Israelites got kicked out of the land. So this does not apply to them. It says it shall return unto the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, thy power, and shall obey his voice, according to all that I command thee this day, thou and thy children with all thine heart and with all thy soul, that then the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, thy power, will turn thy captivity. So he's going to release you out of slavery. Those people were never in captivity. It says, and have compassion upon thee. And how would the Most High have compassion upon them? He would deliver them from their slavery, and he would take those curses off of them. Currently, up to this day, we're still under those curses, man. Like it says in Baruch 3 and 8, we are yet this day in our captivity, where thou hast scattered us for a reproach and a curse, and to be made subject to payments, man. So as long as you got bills, you are under the curses of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai. You got an electric bill, you got to put gas in your car, you got a water bill, you got to pay rent. You got to go to a job and you know, clock in, clock out, or whatever you do. You know, the mere fact that you have to work to survive, that's a curse from the Lord. All right? Because when we get into the kingdom, we ain't going to have to work. You know? It says that then the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, thy power, will turn thy captivity and have compassion upon thee, and will return and gather thee from all the nations whither the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, has scattered thee. And they're saying that this was fulfilled during 1948, which it wasn't. The Most High never picked the 1948ers up from anywhere and set them back in that land, literally. When you read that in the scriptures, the Most High is saying he's going to deliver the nation of Israel from these different countries around the world. That's literal. The Heavenly Father is literally going to scoop up the nation of Israel from wherever, you know, part of the earth they are, and literally set them back in that land through divine means. Verse 4 says, if any of thine be driven out unto the outmost part of heaven, from thence will the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, thy power, gather thee, and from thence will he fetch thee. And the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, thy power, will bring thee into the land which thy fathers possess. Now, did it say the Most High was going to do it, or, you know, the British were going to do this through the Balfour Declaration and the UN? The Most High said he would do it himself. He's not going to use man to do these things. He's not going to use the other nations to implement these things, man. He's going to do it himself. Like the scriptures tell you in Isaiah, the 14th chapter, it says the Lord will have mercy upon Jacob and will yet choose Israel. So all the nations are going to know who the Israelites are. All the nations are going to know, you know, when the Israelites get delivered, that the creator of the heavens and the earth is dealing with these people. Okay, it's going to be made apparent who the chosen people of Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai are. Alright? It says, in the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, thy power will bring thee into the land which thy fathers possessed, and thou shalt possess it, and he will do thee good and multiply thee above thy fathers. And the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, thy power will circumcise thine heart, which this is another prophecy that those people don't fulfill. The circumcision of the heart goes into the establishing of the new covenant, the Heavenly Father putting the laws, statutes, and commandments inside of the minds of the nation of Israel, making them perfect. You wouldn't have a thing called Pink City over there in the land of Israel if the Most High actually, you know, fulfilled, you know, the prophecies and set his people back in that land. It would be incapable for there to be a pink city to exist in the land of Israel amongst the true Israelites, you know. And the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, thy power will circumcise thine heart and the heart of thy seed to love the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, thy power. And what's the love of the Heavenly Father? To keep his commandments. The commandments are not being kept out there in the land of Israel perfectly. They don't even keep the laws. They have currently they have a democracy established. They vote in representatives. Where in the scriptures was there a democracy where people had a vote on who they wanted to be ruler? The Heavenly Father selected the ruler, and the laws were already set. There were no amendments. There were no new laws that were legislated and passed. You know, that's not the kind of government that the Heavenly Father set up. It says to love the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, thy power, with all thine heart and with all thy soul, that thou mayest live. Verse 7, and the Lord, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, thy power, will put all these curses upon thine enemies and on them that hate thee, which persecuted thee. And one of those curses was that when your enemies come out against you, they will flee. Okay, which that's, you you know, that was one of the curses that befell the nation of Israel. So that curse is supposed to be on anybody that comes up against, you know, the Israelites. And them claiming to be Israelites, they would have no, they wouldn't even have it in them to shoot missiles on that place. That thought wouldn't even come to their mind because they would get crushed. You know, and any attempt that they would, you know, try to execute to destroy them would be thwarted by the Heavenly Father. Would be thwarted by the Heavenly Father. And then they would get demolished, man. You wouldn't have any Israelis die from any kind of attacks. An attack would come, the attack would be thwarted, and then the enemies would be conquered, man. But that's not what's going on out there. Okay? Which that's just further proof that those people are not who they say they are. You know, so I just wanted to go into that. Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, willing. It was edifying. I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Baha Shem Yahweh Shai, Baha Shem Arahak Wadash.